This lesson focuses upon chart layouts. You'll remember from Lesson 5.1 that there are three major decisions to make when designing a chart. First, the chart type. In this case, it's a column chart. Then the chart layout. That's the subject of this lesson, the elements the chart contains. And finally, the chart style. Things such as the colours and fonts used on the chart. This lesson focuses completely upon the chart layout, the collection of elements that a chart contains. Let's talk some more now about chart layouts. Here's an example of a chart layout. And you can see that there's a chart title element at the top of the chart, and there are also axis elements to describe the data shown on the chart. Let's talk some more about the axes. A chart normally shows category or non-numerical data along the horizontal axis. The horizontal axis is also sometimes called the x-axis. The vertical axis normally contains numerical data, and the vertical axis is also sometimes called the y-axis. The chart used in this lesson has the non-numerical region categories, that's USA, Europe and other, along the horizontal or x-axis, and the numerical values along the vertical or y-axis. Let's now look at another chart layout example. In this example, I've identified four of the chart elements. First of all, the axis title elements. These describe the values that are shown in the axis elements. And then there's the axis elements themselves. The horizontal x-axis showing USA, Europe and other. And the vertical y-axis showing values. Next, I've identified a legend element. This describes the colour coding used in the bars, so that I can identify which month each bar belongs to. And finally, I've identified the gridline elements. Those are those horizontal lines running across the body of the chart. The gridline elements make it easier to identify which value each bar relates to. Let's move on now to a third example that illustrates the data table element. The data table element shows you the source data that the chart's based upon. So you now should be clear upon what a chart layout is. It's a group of elements that appear on a chart. But it has nothing to do with the chart type or the chart style. So now that we're clear on what a chart layout is, we're ready to progress to the lesson. For this lesson, you need to open the sample file World Sales 2 from your sample files folder. I'm now going to change the chart layout. To do that, I'll click just inside the border of the chart to select it, and notice that the Chart Tools tab has appeared on the ribbon. I'm going to click on the Design tab, and notice that on the left-hand side of the ribbon, there's a Chart Layouts group, and one of the options is Quick Layout. I'll click Quick Layout now, and a gallery appears showing several different chart layouts. It's possible to click on any of the layouts shown in the gallery to apply this layout to the chart. I'm going to select the Layout 9 layout, and when I click, this layout is applied to the chart. Let's look at the elements that this chart layout contains. I can quickly see the name of each element by hovering over it with the mouse. I can see I have a chart title element. I have a vertical value axis title element and also a vertical value axis. Along the bottom, I have a horizontal category axis and also a horizontal category axis title to describe it. And over on the right, I have the legend element. In Lesson 5.9, you're going to learn how to add elements one by one, but you can see how much faster it is to select all 5 elements with a single click, instead of individually adding each one. Let's now edit the text shown in the chart title element. So I'll click on the chart title element and type sales first quarter on the keyboard. And now I'm going to edit the vertical axis title element. I click on the vertical axis title element and I'm going to call this sales. Next, the horizontal axis title element. I click on the element and I'll call this title region. And all that remains for this lesson is to save your work. And I'm going to save this workbook with the new name World Sales 3. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 5.5, Add and Remove Chart Elements Using Quick Layout.